Hello friends, how are you? I hope everyone is doing good. Today we'll see MRI film of the other patient, MRI knee films. So we'll see and we'll come to a conclusion. What's the diagnosis? I saw this patient around 3 to 4 weeks back. He came with a history of some twist injury. I examined his knee, there is a knee effusion. I advised him knee aspiration. So I have done knee aspiration. Then Frank blood was aspirated around 20-30 ml. Then compression bandage was applied. Then again after 10 days he came with, I asked him to come after 10 days, then he came. Examination, I felt there is latchments. I was not sure. I felt some valgus stress positive, and again there is a mild effusion. I told him it's better if you get an MRI, as X-ray was looking normal. Then I advised him MRI knee. He told, okay doctor, we'll decide, we'll discuss with our family and we'll come, we'll let you know, he said. Then he underwent MRI of the knee. So let us read this MRI of the knee in the orthopedic surgeon's point of view. Once again, I am telling, we are not radiologists. We are orthopedic surgeons. For us, clinical examination is very, very important. I am not denying that. I am telling it again that for us, clinical examination is very important. So, in the clinical examination, I told I got latchments positive, then valgus stress positive, and there is a history of trauma. I was not sure about the type of trauma, but there is definitely a history of trauma. Okay, we'll start reading this. We'll try to come to a conclusion. Okay, let us start. Okay, these again, as I said in the previous video, we are reading the MRI in three cuts: sagittal, coronal, axial. Sagittal is from sidewards, coronal is from front to back, axial is as if you are cutting the log. Okay. So now we are seeing the T2 coronal images. So T1 is, in T2 fluid appears white. Okay. We'll start reading this. So quadriceps tendon, patellar tendon looking normal as we go from front to back. There is some effusion there. And as you see here, there is a contusion of the lateral femoral condyle. Okay. So there is a bony contusion of the lateral femoral condyle and also the tibial plateau. Okay. So other than this, what else we'll see? We have to see the MCL. How is MCL? See? How is MCL? So there is a tear in the MCL here. Okay guys. So that might be the reason why I was getting valgus stress positive. Okay. So for me, the anterior horns, the meniscus, both anterior and both medial and lateral are looking normal. And again, as we are going little posterior, PCL is looking intact. See, I am appreciating a gap between the lateral femoral condyle and the ACL. There is some fluid which should we never seen. As you know, the ACL arises from the lateral femoral condyle. Usually there should not be any gap between the lateral femoral condyle and the ACL, but here we are able to see some gap. So empty notch sign is seen. What is empty notch sign? In coronal and axial images, we should never see a fluid between ACL and the lateral femoral condyle. If you see some fluid, then empty notch sign is positive. Okay, then we will read the sagittal images. So yesterday, as we discussed, we are going from the medial to the lateral side. Medial side, the proximal tibia is triangular. Okay, so anterior horns of the medial, anterior and the posterior horns of the medial menisci are looking normal. Okay guys, then patellar tendon is looking normal, quadriceps tendon is looking normal. See, there is a buckling of the PCL. See, there is a buckling of the PCL. Okay, I do not see, I am not able to see any double PCL sign or triple PCL sign. So guys, what is double PCL sign and what is triple PCL sign? That's for you today. Please read about that and comment in the comment section below. Where is the ACL? Where is the ACL? See, there is a discontinuity of the fibers of the ACL. So to diagnose an ACL tear, you have to see both the primary signs and the secondary signs. Primary signs are very important. They are discontinuity of the ACL fibers on T2, abnormality in the orientation. Normally they are oriented parallel to the intercondylar roof, that is Blumensatz line, or they are more steeper. They are never less steeper. Means if the ACL is looking flat, means it is torn. Got it? So number one, discontinuity. Number two, abnormal orientation. Number three, abnormal signal. Normally, ACL is low signal in T2. That means it looks blackish in T2. Whereas in acute ACL tear, it's a high signal. Means it looking more whitish. Layman's language. Usually low signal in T2. Entire high signal. So coming to the secondary signs, as we discussed yesterday, bone contusion on the lateral femoral condyle and Segond's fracture. Did we see for Segond's fracture in the coronal view? No. Let us see. What is Segond's fracture? It's an avulsion fracture of the lateral collateral band. Okay, I don't see any Segond's fracture here. I am not able to see. Okay guys, then anterior tibial translation of more than 7 mm. One of the secondary sign, PCL buckling, avulsion fracture of the tibial insertion. I don't see any avulsion fracture at the tibial insertion site. Decreased PCL angle and all. Positive PCL line sign. So read about what is positive PCL line sign. Okay guys. And of course, this is a trauma. There is a trauma history in this patient. Otherwise, you should also see for any mucoid degeneration in the ACL or for any ganglion cysts in the ACL. Okay. For tibial translation, anterior tibial translation, we are looking at the sagittal views. So in the coronal, we have seen for the MCL, we have not seen for the LCL, okay? I mean postrolateral complex. So what are the three things you see for the postrolateral complex? One is the fibular collateral ligament, biceps femoris tendon, and the popliteus tendon. So we'll see for the fibular collateral ligament. Fibular collateral ligament, as you know, it doesn't arise exactly from the lateral epicondyle. It arises 1.4 mm proximal and 3.1 mm posterior. Just remember 1 mm proximal, 3 mm posterior to the lateral epicondyle. Both are piece. And it inserts to the lateral aspect of the fibular head. Okay, guys. So here we are able to see the V-shaped thing attaching into the fibular head. So that is V is formed one by the lateral collateral ligament, other by the biceps femoris tendon. Okay, guys. The lateral collateral ligament or the fibular collateral ligament is coming 1 mm proximal and 3 mm posterior to the lateral epicondyle and attaching to the lateral aspect of the fibular head. And other limb is formed by the biceps femoris tendon. Okay. So, and also we should see for the popliteus tendon, which I am not, that's what I said, I am not a radiologist. I am not very trained to see popliteus tendon. In this MRI films, I am not able to appreciate the popliteus tendon. Popliteal vessels are looking alright for me. Okay, guys. What is the arcuate? What is arcuate fracture? It's an avulsion fracture of the head of the fibula, which indicates tear of the PLC. So there is no any arcuate fracture also. So I think we have finished the coronal and sagittal. That's what I think. Okay, guys, we have seen the patella, patellar cartilage, we have seen quadriceps tendon, we have seen patellar tendon, we have seen articular cartilage of the femur, we have seen there is some small defect at the lower aspect of the femur. Maybe see here, maybe small osteochondral fragment of the femur, which I have not seen in the x-ray. Other than this, I am not able to appreciate anything more in the coronal and the sagittal views. Okay, guys, we'll go for the next image. So these images we have already seen. This. Okay, guys, we'll see. We'll see for the axial we'll see for the axial images now. In the axial images, yesterday we have seen which is lateral and which is medial. How do we tell tell? By looking at the fibula. Now we are not able to see the fibula here. So we'll see here, look at the meniscus. Okay, guys. So for me, again, we have already seen there is a contusion in the posterolateral aspect of the femur. So that's what we are again seeing here, even in these pictures, and again we are seeing the contusion of the posterolateral aspect of the tibia. Other than that, I am not seeing anything more. Actually, we should also check for the MPFL. I am not able to appreciate here. Okay, we'll go for the next. Even this we are looking at the same thing. So read about the MCL. What is superficial MCL, deep MCL? Okay, the superficial MCL, it arises from the medial epicondyle it inserts 7 centimeters below the joint line, below inferomedial geniculate vessels. So in this video, the positive findings what I have observed are tear of the ACL. I am not sure it's a partial or complete, but definitely there is a tear. So we'll see once again. Yeah, I think mid-substance tear, I think, because there is a discontinuity in the fibers. And other features what I am able to observe is bony contusion in the posterolateral aspect of the tibia, bony contusion in the posterolateral tibial plateau, buckling of the PCL, tear of the MCL, and osteochondral fragment in the lateral femoral condyle. I'm not sure about this. There's some, definitely it's not looking normal. So I hope this video is helpful to you. If you like this video, please give a like for this, so that it gives me an inspiration to make more videos. Please comment in the comment section below whatever doubts you have. Okay guys, and at the end, I am asking you guys to read about ghost meniscus. What is ghost meniscus? What is a double PCL sign? What is a triple PCL sign? What is reverse Sigand fracture? I hope I'll get answers from you guys for these questions in the comment section below. Okay guys, bye bye.